much my Father loved. And I love him very much. And I sat there right over in Richmond in his hospital. And I watched him gasp over air. I sat right beside him with my hand on his hand. And he would just reach for the next breath. He'd reach for the next breath. He'd reach for the next breath. And I said, God, it's just any minute now. And then God got on me right there. And he said, what has he built? What has he built? What has he done? How much money does he have? Is his bank account full? Or is his family? What are they? And God spoke to me again. And he said, it does not matter anymore. It don't matter anymore what he's got. Only thing he's got to worry about is the Lamb of God and whether his soul was right. Amen. So if you're building a home, if you've got a job and it's burning you down tonight, I'm begging you to come to this altar and say, God, nothing matters but you. He's the most important thing that you'll ever have in your life. Oh, he's the way, he's the truth and the life. And so many people take it for granted and turn, and they walk away from the light of the world and turn into the everlasting darkness. And that don't care nothing for them, that don't want to do nothing for them, that don't want to help them in any way, and they won't come to the cross. Oh, oh, holy night. The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining until he appeared and your soul felt its worth. Oh my God. Oh my God. I will never forget it. I will never forget it. I was so miserable, filthy, nasty wretch. Oh, I don't deserve to be here tonight. Oh, but because of what he done, because of the love that he had, I can stand here tonight and tell you that he is the most wonderful thing that's ever touched its toe to God's earth. He is the most beautiful piece of equipment, the beautiful most piece of man, the beautiful most piece of God. He is everything all in all. He's wonderful. There's nothing that can outdo him. There's nothing that can outlast him. There's nothing that can outpower him. There's nothing that can outlive him. There's nothing that can outthirst him. There's nothing that can outhunger him. He is the way. I'm telling you tonight, if you don't got Jesus, you don't have anything. He's wonderful. I praise him. Thank him. Brothers, take up an offering. I praise him. He's wonderful. He's wonderful. He is the way, he is the truth, and he is the life. And he is real, and he's in this house tonight, and he's looking at your soul. I'm telling you, if your heart and your mind's on God, I'm telling you tonight to give him everything you've got and don't look back. If your mind's on sin, you better turn right now. You haven't got time to be playing with Satan. You ain't got time to be playing with houses and cars and drugs. You ain't got time to be goofing off with the world affairs. Come to this altar and weep. Come to this altar and pray. Seek his face every single day. I praise him for everything. I can't honor him enough. If I could only tell you what I used to be, you wouldn't believe it. I'm still amazed that I can stand here tonight. Oh, and feel his presence from the inside to the out. I praise him. He can save anybody. He can wash anybody's sins away. If you're lost tonight, I want you to come and pray and give your heart to him. Seek him. If you're getting cold, if you're getting cold, it ain't his fault. It ain't his fault. Come tonight. If you're take up an altar, brother. I'm sorry. I'm going to take his service over. He's just wonderful. He's so wonderful. He is so wonderful. He is so wonderful. I thank him for all he's done for me. I thank him for all he's done for you, because he never had to do none of it. Yeah.
God can do anything. I know.
God can do anything.
I have a 38 to my head today. But I didn't do it.
Yeah.
I talked to Sister Amber. She said, get ready. I'm going to get you. You're going to church with me.
That's right.
I've been hurt a lot in my life. I couldn't forgive. But I can now. And I turned it over to God. And I've been raised in church all my life.
Yeah.
It's just I've been going to a church for 5 years and was asked to leave. They have. That hurt. That hurt deeply. And it took everything in me. The other night on Sunday to come through that door because I didn't know if I was going to come in and get hurt. Or go through the same thing I did. But I still need everybody's prayers.
Amen.
To get my family back. I've lost everybody.
Yes.
But I appreciate it. Y'all so love us. Y'all so love us. And that's my God now.
Yeah.
That's my God too.
Who taught the sun where to stand?